Hello again at a next video on the ECOS 2 progressions on my little oval, what is it, train layout. Well, it's not really a layout, it's just an oval for testing and experimenting purposes. What I was trying to do is to connect a computer with, let's say, Rockrail software or Koploper, the Dutch program Koploper software. And what you always need is track sensors to monitor where your trains are. And usually that is done with an S88 board. And what I was trying to do is to do that with this little brother over here. That's an Arduino mini computer. And why would you do that? You might ask. Well, two reasons, just for fun. It's interesting to play around with an Arduino and write some software and get it to do the things you want to do. But the other purpose could be that if you buy an S88 board, a 16 input board, will set you back some 40 euros. And this little guy, the Arduino, sets you back only 6 euros. So if you need 5 of those boards, it's already over 100 euros, 200 euros difference. So that might be interesting. What I did is put some software in. You might ask, where did you get that software? Well, nowhere. I tried to browse the internet and there were several attempts, but nothing really available. So I did write a small program myself and I'm now in the testing phase. I do not have real sensors on the track yet. I'm using this, well, let me zoom in a bit. Zoom in, that's this way. I am using a switch panel. I hope that now everything is in view. Yes, should be. This is the Arduino over here connected with the S88 bus of the ECOS, and these red switches are 4 sensors that I simulate by just pressing a button. I connected this all to the Koploper program. The Koploper program is on the PC over here. Okay, let me have a look here. Well, that probably cannot even be seen here on the video very well, or not at all. There is a Koploper running over there. It's connected via Wi-Fi, and the ECOS is of course on the router. And what I can do is let one locomotive run. Now I need to zoom out a bit again. Well, this video is becoming a little bit chaotic. But I just would like to show you that it works. Oh, better first show on the ECOS that it works, because the ECOS has a detection circuit for the S88, and I can go there via settings and then the link, then the S88 bus, and then this go there button. Now you see 16 bits of the first S88 board. Well, I have only one S88 board simulated here by the Arduino, and I have 4 sensors connected. If I press this button, we should see here, over here, the first bit is lighting, and the second bit, and the third bit, and the fourth bit. So the connection to the ECOS is working. And if it works with the ECOS will send the data to the Koploper program on my PC. Well, I hope that was a bit visible. And then let's have a look finally at the whole bunch together. So the Arduino is now simulating an S88 detector board. I'm going to start Koploper, run the trains on automatic mode. Yeah, there it goes. You may be able to see this locomotive is now on the run. Here on the ECOS, my button is rotating very slowly, and also the speed monitor on the ECOS is running very slowly. That is because I have set a terribly slow acceleration in. Okay, I will now simulate that it is in the next block, entering that block. I press the button and you can see probably that right now Koploper, the computer program, decided that we're going to brake to a minimum speed, waiting till we meet the next sensor, where it will brake to a full stop. It has now reached its minimum speed and I'm now simulating the next sensor. And now the lock will come to a full stop. Can we see that? Yeah, we can see that because right now it is stopping. All right, koploper decides how many seconds it is halted. 1, 2, 3, it is going again. And well, you can see it is very, very slowly on the move. That we can see also on the koploper screen that it is very slowly going to the top speed, a very slow acceleration. And then I'm going to simulate that it is entering the next block. I'm pressing the button now. We can see that the lock is slowing down. And we can also see over here that it is slowing down. And it should be probably at its slowest speed now. I'm going to press the next sensor button. And now you will see it come to a halt. Well, what did it prove? That proved only one thing, that it is possible to use an Arduino, a very mini computer that sets you back only 6 euros, to simulate an S88 board. The software is available, I will publish that on the internet, it goes with the text with the video, it's also on my blog. So anyone who would like to do this too and save yourself some dollars or euros, you're welcome to download the software and use it yourself, of course. Next thing to do is to get rid of these push buttons that simulate my sensors and use a real sensor. For that I created this little wooden block and the sensor is already in. It's going to be an optical sensor. I'm not sure if it shows on the video. Optical sensor. This one over here, it is sending infrared light and that other guy is receiving infrared light and I made this little wooden block so that I can put it in and put it next to the track. But of course in the real, this is only for test purposes, in the real track I plan to have these sensors installed underneath the track and as you can see that fits really, really nice there. You won't even really see that very much. And that is also going to work. I already tested this infrared sensor, works very fine. Maybe I can do a very short video on that, including the software, in the next video. Well, thank you for watching. Bye bye, and maybe see you later again.